It is Freshers Week again, and tonight is the 2023 YUSU Comedy Night. Are you excited for the event?
Very excited, yeah.
And do you have any jokes for us before you hear these jokes?
Okay, how did the Dachshund die?
I don't know.
Walked around the tree until it met its end.
Oh, I would think of a good chemistry joke, but all the good ones are gone. There we are. It's terrible, but that's what you get.
It didn't get a reaction either.
No, it didn't. Jamie, you betrayed me.
Alright, and so now I'm speaking with some YUSU officers.
It's been so busy, but it's been so good. Like, the turnout for today has been insane. Everyone seems to be loving Freshers so far, and that is all we can really ask for.
Are you excited for the event tonight?
Yes, I'm really excited. Really, really excited. I love stand-up, so yeah, very, very hyped.
Is there a particular comedian you're most excited for?
Yeah, definitely. I love Fern Brady. She's one of my...
Yeah,
I'm also fellow Scot, so that'll make me feel slightly less alone down south.
How is your Freshers Week so far?
It's been really good. It's been really fun. I've met a lot of new people. I've had some fun events going on. I've been really enjoying it, yeah.
How have you found the week so far?
Pretty good. Met loads of people, including these.
Everyone's really friendly, yeah?
Yeah, everyone's really nice.
And did you enjoy the first half of the show?
Yeah, it was really funny.
It was good, yeah.
Yeah, it's my first stand-up comedy gig, so yeah.
And what was it like having the having the comedian speak to you?
It was pretty cool, but a bit embarrassing.
Oh, so far it's been brilliant. We knew you were going to get picked on.
Yeah. It was hilarious, really. Like, I loved every bit of it. And I love also getting involved in the show, like having jokes done at me. It was really fun.
It's been good. We're in third year now, so reality's setting in, so we need comedy night for it.
What have you thought of the comedy so far?
Yeah, it was really good. I mean, I've never heard of Jodie Mitchell before, but I really liked it. I thought she was hilarious. And I'm really looking forward to Fern Brady. I'm from Scotland, and so it's always nice to see like a Scottish comedian.
I'm Jodie Mitchell. I'm a stand-up comedian and a drag king.
Do you have any advice maybe for the freshers here?
Oh, just enjoy it. It's so scary and you meet so many new people, but Freshers Week was literally when I realised I wanted to do stand-up comedy, and you don't have to have a big life realisation in Freshers Week. I think I was quite drunk when I decided that. But it worked out for me, and I'm glad that I threw myself in. So I think just throw yourself in would be my advice.
Do you have any advice for people looking to go into maybe stand-up comedy?
It's quite a long road, and you'll die on your ass quite a lot. But it's all very character building. I was told that quite early on when I started, that it would be character building, it'd be really difficult. And I was quite dismissive about that. But actually, every time that you do badly, you learn so much from it. And you meet the best people and some of the worst people, and you learn to stay clear of them. Like, I do a lot of queer comedy and a lot of stuff around identity, so it always feels very silly to be like, oh, it's meaningful comedy. I don't mean it like that at all, but I think representation is really important. So the best thing is feeling like you are like representing a group that maybe you didn't see represented when you were growing up. Like, I didn't really see like non-binary comedians on TV when I was growing up, and I feel really pleased that like I'm doing that now, and so many of my amazing friends are doing that now. And I guess the worst part is probably green rooms of only cis male comedians that don't look at you, but then it returns to the best part when you go on stage and smash it, and then they all feel like little worms, so that's quite fun. Yeah.
So obviously the job relies heavily on audiences. Do you have any like moments with audiences which maybe stick out to you as being particularly good or interesting?
I've done a lot of like very eclectic gigs, I guess, like especially because I do drag kinging as well, and I do comedy as my male alter ego, John Travolta, and I think that's probably where I've had the best audiences, because drag king nights are so raucous and so intense, and people really throw themselves into it. But I've also done a lot of straight stand-up gigs where audience members have just been wild. I mean, I did a gig last week where I did a joke about Catholicism, which I often do. And a priest was in the front row, and he crossed himself, and everyone saw, and it created this beautiful tension in the room.
I think comedy is like the great unifier, because it's something that people don't they don't dismiss it. If something's funny, it's funny, and it will make them listen to what you're actually saying. Whereas often people will dismiss you just based on who you are if you're just talking to them. And obviously that's a problem in comedy as well. Like, people can still be really, really dismissive, but the more of us are talking about stuff that matters, or I guess the more of us that are choosing not to talk about things that are destructive or hurtful, the less it happens. Like, you can see that change happening in the comedy industry, much slower than in any other industry, because it's the home of It's Just a Joke. But it is happening, and it feels like just as important now as it did when I started.